These streets are raw. They should call me Sherlock Homie. But they don't. And maybe they shouldn't. My gosh. A sparkle. An unholy glitter in this urban wasteland. I adjust my shades. Passerby are impressed. The cab is far, but still a twinkle on a busy plain of despair. The skies have no mercy. The driver knows me. His name is Juan. He's unprofessional. Hello, Juan.
Hello?
Why don't you address me by my name?
I don't know your name.
You know me. Guess.
No.
Careless guess. Detective.
You're lying.
Yes. Yes, I am. We've arrived. I wish we hadn't. His voice is soothing, unlike the one that sent me here. She'd lost something, that pesky duchess, and I was sent to find it. Probably a necklace, for she was stereotype incarnate. Goodbye, Juan.
Not my name.
But I've already gone. Gone far from one Juan. The building looms. Only 20 stories high, but thousands of stories abound within, and I know half of them. The Duchess is not a Duchess. She's a tycoon. She owns oil. She sells oil. This gives her money. My case file is explicit in this regard. She has an inappropriate habit of giving the money to you in a sealed envelope by hand, as opposed to sliding it across a desk in dim lighting. Her lighting is bright. And her lampshades bring all the boys to the yard. She's been targeted often, but the exiled Swiss Guard members that form her retinue are well trained. But this time they failed her. She was too frantic on the phone to get into details. Details are for the weak, and she's far from it. I walk into the building, or does it walk into me? Has her vanity and vain procedure overcome me? I yearn to set it all behind. Cue flashback, and flashback. Someone's back flashes. They're wearing two chains, but backwards. Regardless, I walk over to him, and I kick him. This is Alphonse. He's deserved this kick for years, but I've not seen him for months. He nods approvingly. He knows he deserved it. I continue. The elevator is the staircase of the weak. In this moment, I am weak. The escalator is the purgatorial no man's land of the impressionable. I avoid it. Also, it's been decommissioned because it is from the third world and has led to 15 deaths. They call it the Orphan Maker. They disgust me. Anyway, the elevator. It reeks of fish. There are several fish, some dead, some alive, strewn haphazardly around the elevator floor. I squish some, staining my polished inspector boots. The closed doors devolve to an open state, and I am at the top. The agency will cover the boots. I am the agency. I have agency. I am the revolution, and the world revolves around me. The Swiss Guard disarms me as I step in. She's there. Distraught, hopeless, hopeful, mad. Her gown flows like something that flows. I'm too taken aback from the front with a sudden hug to offer anything more poetic. Ever since he left her, she's grown more nervous and insecure. I don't know what for. She walks into her chambers proper and my head turns to follow. My body follows. She sits upon the couch and invites me to sit beside her. I do so, but too slowly. And there is Alphonse. A sad wreck to be forgot. I snap out of it. Her voice.
Let's get some air.
Yes.
There's an issue.
Yes.
A mystery.
Yes.
Can you solve it?
What is it?
Something's been taken from me.
A necklace.
My child.
You have no children.
I will speak figuratively regarding my necklace.
Naturally. My mistake. Describe the necklace.
Imagine the last 12 necklaces you recovered for me.
I see them in my head as clearly as I see them around your neck.
Please don't stare at my chest. You're making me uncomfortable.
Yes, of course. I apologize.
That's why I said imagine. I know I wear them now.
Well, why wear them if you don't want people to stare? One by one, she reveals a cyanide capsule hidden within each necklace.
The Vietnamese will never get me.
The war is over.
But the state of war is perpetual. There is no deliverance but in death, and cyanide is my mailman. And it in turn is delivered by these necklaces. My necklaces are my mailman, I suppose. I suppose I have an unholy fleet of mailmen, each one more Gucci than the last.
So the stolen necklace?
Yes, I must have it back at once.
How much cyanide do you need?
Whatever kills me makes me stronger. I need a lot, but this is different. This necklace is my mother's.
Good God.
Yes, help me find it.
Of course. Who do you suspect?
I suspect Alphonse.
Some mysteries are easier than others. I suspected this would fall into the easy category. All she needed me for was to enforce. And enforce I shall. 3 hours later, I've arrived at Alphonse's hovel. He's making eggs. I ask for none. He gives me 3. Awkward. He doesn't suspect a thing. His chains are still backwards. Is there a connection between his backwards chains and her necklace? I cannot fathom it. I approach the issue straightly. Where is her necklace?
I stole it.
Irrelevant. You've been kicked. The punishment carries over the new crime, despite my obliviousness during its implementation. Where is it?
Bradley has it.
Bradley.
Agreed. He has everything. Bullion, cattle, cacti, turkey imported from Spain. The whole shebang.
I know. Who do you think overrode the customs men's prohibition on his imports?
I don't know.
It was I.
I see.
Where can I find Bradley?
He's at the zoo. The only place he goes now. He's left society. The zebras do not accept him, but he does not care.
Don't lie to me, Alphonse.
He's at the business center. He has business there of the utmost importance.
Don't lie to me, Alphonse.
He's cycling on the...
Don't lie to me, Alphonse.
He's recycling the verbal implements of his confidence.
You. Shut up. I don't believe you. I grab the knife. There was no knife, but I grab it. I manifest it with the sheer force of my will and the strength of my drive.
Thank you.
there. It is not real, but he feels its presence as real and is alert to its threat. He's convinced. His fear is evinced. I push deeper with the knife of my spirit and stab all layers of pervasive muck from his heart away as if it were the skin of a chicken. He screams, that chicken.
Oh, Morgan!
But she will not come, for she has grander aims. I aim closer to his soul, and it seems he will fold.
I am Bradley.
Oh my god. Be real. But he's telling the truth. He is Bradley. I'm in shock. So if Bradley has the necklace, then Alphonse is Bradley. Alphonse must have the necklace. The mystery deepens. I'm staring off into space now in deep syllogistic thought when I look to him and see another glitter. Another sparkle. This time it's not his chain. It is the necklace. The swagger of his chains disguise them, but no longer. Well, I'm good. You had the necklace.
Yes! I said that already. You win, okay?
I solved the mystery. Take that, Alphonse.
I don't think this really counts as a mystery.
I repeat, take that, Alphonse. He took it. He took it to heart, and he took to his inside the cyanide built within the necklace. Time passes. Alphonse is dead. The necklace is mine. I must return it.
Connor, what the hell?